In this movie, we're going to become more familiar with Final Cut Pro 10.62's new object tracker features by tracking a 3D piece of text to this clip that you see here. We're then going to finalize this shot by using Continuum FCP as well as BCC Composite, which will allow us to make a cutout of the subject. Then after performing the cutout, we'll add BCC plus streaks, which will only show up around the subject's edges to add some production value to the shot. Let's get started. So I have a project here with the clip that we would like to use. The first thing that we're going to do is move to the beginning of the project, and let's go to the titles and generators sidebar. In the 3D category is a piece of custom 3D text, and this is what we're going to object track to the scene first. In order to do this, I'll select the text and drag it directly into the viewer. We want to select this computer monitor over here on the right. And now I'm going to take this box, which is the tracking region, and I'm going to make it a lot smaller. So really, it just fits in the computer monitor. Now, it just so happens that our text has separate controls. In fact, we can move it separately from the tracking region. This is because of some of the features that are turned on under the tracker. To see this, if you click the downward arrow, you can see the tracking source is set to the video. We're currently using the object track. We can even create a new tracker from here. And the behavior of the text is offset from the tracker, so it won't be attached to it. The other thing we can do is actually apply, besides position and rotation data, scale data. You can see there that the text does change to scale all fit if that was required, but we'll leave scaling off for the time being here in the shot. I'll click the arrow once again to close the menu. Let's extend the length of our text to match the length of our clip. I'll select the text and then click on the Analyze button here in the top right-hand corner. Let's see how it does with the track. You can see that it seems to get thrown off a little bit by the object track of the screen. In fact, if I play this back, you'll see a bit too much of a wiggle with the custom 3D text there. In order to fix this, let's just try a different tracking method. I'm going to select the clip and I'm going to head to the inspector. So this is the actual clip, not the text. At the bottom of the clip where that object tracker is, and we can see its data, we can change the analysis method from automatic to point cloud. So we'll track a point instead. I'll select the text and let's just do another analysis and see how it does. You can see there are a lot less bouncing around there with the track of the analysis, and it appears to be done. And let's do a full screen playback of the track so far. That's looking pretty good. I'll press escape to exit that. Now let's make some changes to our text. I will click done to exit the tracker. So now we have some controls specifically for our 3D text. We can double click to change the name of it. I'll type in the hacker and then I'll press escape. Let's change the font to Montserrat. If you don't have this, it's a Google font. You can download it directly from them. I'll bring down the size in this case. And then I'm going to make the text semi-bold. One great thing about 3D text is that I can actually move it in X, Y, and Z dimension space, not to mention use these handy little rotation handles to pivot as well as change the way that the text's perspective is, besides just your regular rotation. And also go into our lighting settings, where we can choose from a number of lighting styles for how the light interacts with our plastic material here. Now that we have our text pretty much in the scene where we want it to be, let's now create a cutout of our subject. So to start this off, first of all, I'm going to make a duplicate copy of this clip, the footage, and place it above the text. I can option click and drag that up, so it's just above my text layer. Awesome. And now we can see it obscures the text. Let's head to our effects browser. And under the BCC key and blend category, we're going to grab BCC composite and place it on this clip. This one effect with the opacity value here, and if you don't see this setting, you can just reveal it here by pressing the show button on the top right of the effect, will allow us to create a cutout of our subject. So in fact, if I make that opacity zero, you can see here that the entire image disappears by default. Now, the cool thing is, though, if we use Mocha masking, we can limit the lowering of the opacity of this clip to just a specific region. So let's get some instant gratification right away by going to Mocha Masking. I'm going to create a really simple shape. You should note that there is a getting started with Mocha video if you're just new to this in FCP that you might want to check out before this video. I'll be going over some of these tools rather quickly. I'm going to click and drag a really simple circle on my subject and then just sort of define a region that I want to track that has a lot of texture here. And even just using this shape right now without any tracking, we can see this update in Final Cut. So I'm going to close out this window, going to press save. We head immediately back to Final Cut, and you should see a circle there in the area that I just defined with my shape inside of Mocha. Now, the cool part about this is if I go into Pixel Chooser under the mask section and invert this mask, only what's inside the circle now shows up. Everything else is a cutout. So we can now see the text underneath here. So let's now just define a much better shape. I'll go back into Mocha Masking, and we can actually use this really simple circle for our tracking information. So to do that, on the top left-hand corner, here's the layer. We'll call it track. And we don't need to track skew. We'll track translation, scale, and rotation. And let's first of all track backward. Now I'll move this playhead at the bottom back to the first point that I created there on the clip, which is in the middle and identified by that green mark, and then click the track forward button. Excellent. So now if I just actually click on the backward play button here at the bottom, I can see that this looks like a pretty successful track there of the texture that I decided with a very simple shape. And we can now take this simple shape and actually attach more complex shapes, which we're going to use to create the actual cutout. Let me stop playback. We're going to now grab the magnetic spline tool here and create a shape of the hacker's head. So I'm just going to press Z to zoom in on the shot so we can see it more clearly, followed by X to temporarily activate the hand tool. And I'll follow around the edges here of the hacker. You can see here how that magnetic tool for corners or edges have some contrast from the background are no problem at all to create a shape. I'll go here and double click on the first point. There's the head of the hacker. I'll press Command A to select all of these points and then just click and drag in to make that a little bit more round. Then click off once, select the layer again, and make any refinements that are required. All right, so now that I have this layer, I'll rename it head. With it selected, we're just going to link it to the simple circular shape that we tracked. So I'm just going to set track and then just also make sure to change the color of the head to green. Right away, if I started to move my playhead, we can see that it does a fairly good job of linking to the circle, but there is a bit of refinement that we need to do. What makes Mocha so great with dealing with these situations is that I could now adjust this entire shape to move with the head in the position that it needs to be, because the layer is selected. Also take a series of points and refine them, bring them in because the shape is smaller. And Mocha is going to adapt or interpolate from that first point that I created because it doesn't create keyframes on every frame. It keeps that information separate. I'll just make some refinements here of this mask over time to perfect how it looks. So you should know that this entire process of refining that head took just a couple minutes to do. All right, let me press the X tool. I'll hold it down just to temporarily activate the hand tool and then zoom out so we can see our entire subject.
Now, it's important to note a time-saving tip in Mocha is to create masks only in the areas that you need them. Masking the entire body of the individual gives me more opportunity to play around where I want to position it in post, though. In this instance, I'm doing the entire body because I want to have a light rays effect around the gentleman's edges. But when it comes to the text, it's only going to appear on his right shoulder.
We'll create a second shape here, but just this time using the X-spline tool around our whole subject. And then double click to click on that first point. I'll press Command A just to select all the points around and drag inward. Then select that layer once again and make any refinements for some of the points here that need refinement on a second check now that I see the entire shape. I'll take this layer and we'll rename it body, give it a color of also green here, and then with it selected, make sure that it's linked to the actual track. Again, we're going to need to do some refinement here on various frames just to perfect this. Now that I've scrubbed a bit forward, You can see here at the bottom of the mask needs to be adjusted. And we can see here how it will interpolate between the last frame of my project and what I just created. But we can go to specific frames and then perfect this. All right. Now that I've made those refinements on several different frames, you can see they're represented by the green arrows. This is looking pretty good. We can always go back into Mocha and make further adjustments. Well, let's see how this now looks inside of Final Cut. I'll just make sure also that before we go that we turn off the visibility for the track because we don't need to see it. We just need the head and the body. That will be our cutout. I will click this button to close Mocha and press save. And now here in Final Cut, I can see that the cutout was pretty successful. Excellent. Let's actually turn on the background footage, press the V key, and we'll make a little bit of an adjustment there to our text just to perfect it. I'm going to click V to turn off the clip on the top track. Just select the hacker text and take hacker and place it a line lower. And then with the entire text selected, let's left align it. Excellent. Place it just right over there around his shoulder and then press the V key. So it has successfully been obscured by the above layer. So in terms of the placement of this text, we want it to kind of be in a way where our audience can, of course, view it, but at the same time that part of it is obscured. So I'm just going to play with the size and position of the hacker text just to get it right there into frame so it's eventually revealed. In terms of refinement of the mask, of course, you can select this shape and under Pixel Chooser, it might be nice to add just a little bit of a feather to the edges of our subject. So I'll just press 2. We can hop into Mocha just to perfect that mask even further. Now to add just one final effect, we'll go to the BCC Lights category. And under this category, you'll see a BCC Streaks effect. We'll apply that to the clip on the top and just notice how the rays are limited just to around the edges of our subject. It's not strong enough, so we can go hide the properties of the BCC composite effect, show the BCC streak, where we'll increase the brightness of the effect so we can see it a bit better, and then also play with the range, which is what pixels are being currently affected or being used for this. And if we wanted to, of course, we could increase the amount of horizontal streaks as well to soften this a bit. And now let's just take a playback of our actual project. So to recap, we used the object tracker in Final Cut to track our hacker text to the scene. And we then used Continuum FCP in order to create a cutout of our hacker, limiting the streak effect to the subject and obscuring our 3D text. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to follow us on our YouTube channel. I'd love to hear what other tips you would love to learn about Continuum FCP 2022.